Hello. In this project, you have to build a search engine. Maybe not as complicated as Google or Bing, but a decent enough search engine. This project is divided into three parts. In the first part that has been assigned now, you have to use the TF-IDF relevance model to rank the web pages. The good thing about this project is that we will be using a state-of-the-art library to do much of the grunt work in building a search engine. This is called Lucene, and it was built by the Apache Software Foundation, the same guys behind the Apache web server and technologies like Hadoop and Cassandra. To begin with, read through the problem statement, and then download the source code from the project page over here. The bundle that you downloaded contains a number of things. It has a Lucene index, which contains all of the information that Lucene needs to perform searches, and it also contains a piece of sample code that you can use as your starting point. If you look into this source, you will find that it has some very useful functions in it. To start with, we have the indexReader.open function that opens the index in the folder called index. This index has information about all the documents, all the terms in the documents, and the inverted index. Note that we have stored the indexReader in the variable r. So what can we do with this indexReader? To start with, we can find out how many documents are indexed in the store by calling the maxdoc function. If you ran this code, you would find that it has 25,054 documents. Second, you can figure out what kind of terms there are in the index. If you want to go through each and every term, you can do so by using the term enum object you create by calling the terms function on the index reader. You can then iterate through the term enum and get all the text of the terms by calling term.text. When you're searching for something, you need to be able to create a term of your own. You can do so with the term constructor. This constructor takes two parameters. The first parameter is the field of the term. In this project, you should always set this to contents. If you were building additional capabilities such as indexing and searching for URLs or the titles of the pages, then you could index and search for other fields in this term. The second parameter in the constructor is the word that you want to search for. In this case, I'm going to search for the word brute. Now that I have a term, I can find all the documents that contain this term. I do that by using the termDocs function on the index reader. This gives me a termDocs object that I can iterate through and find all of the document numbers as well as the number of times that this document contains that term. From the document number, one can find the URL of the document by using these three lines of code. The rest of the code shows a small worked out example where the query input is taken from the user and all the URLs of the document that contain that term are shown to the user without any sorting. Lucene is a state-of-the-art system, so it has all the functions that you need to build a fully functional search engine. So if you just use those functions, there is no point to doing this project. Therefore, you are required to only use the Lucene functions that are shown here in this sample code, and no other functions from Lucene. Functions from the standard Java library are obviously fair game. If there is any confusion, just ask us on Piazza. Okay, now let's get back to the problem statement. The first task, task 0, requires you to download, compile, and understand the sample code. Task 1 is about ranking the results with TF without using IDF. Note that the formula for TF requires you to divide by the document norm, and the accurate value of document norm is not available through Lucene. So you will have to compute the document norm, store it somewhere in file or in memory, and then you should prompt the user for a query and print out the resulting document numbers and document URLs. Task 2 is the same as task 1, but you use TF-IDF instead of just TF. Now let's talk about what you have to submit. Email your code, properly commented, to the TA. Print out the top 10 document numbers for each of the given queries and attach it to your report. Write 2 to 3 sentences about the algorithm and any interesting points or challenges that you've faced. For the majority of the points in this project, however, you have to analyze the speed of the algorithm and the correctness of the results. In order to analyze the speed of the algorithm, you have to do three things. The first thing you have to do is to evaluate which part of the algorithm took the most time. The second asks how the speed changes as you use TF only or TF-IDF. And the third task is to analyze the speed of the algorithm as you increase the number of terms in your query. Please give these questions some thought before you answer them. As with most experiments, there is a right way of doing them and a wrong way of doing them. There are some extra credit questions that you can answer, and of course, any additional interesting analysis can be submitted for extra credit. Finally, you have to analyze the correctness of the results. For this part, run various queries on your system and judge whether you would be satisfied with these results as a regular user of the system. You also have to compare TF versus IDF, and you have to find those terms which have the lowest IDF in the corpus. You must explain any of the results that you obtain. And that's it. Good luck with your project. Thank you.